Good morning, students. In the last lecture, we have seen the Gauss elimination method and Jacobi's method to solve the linear system of equation. Now, today we are going to discuss the Gauss-Seidel method, which is a very efficient method to solve the linear system of equation. So, let us look the method. The Gauss-Seidel method, we also call this method as a method of successive displacement. So how here we will learn how we will study iterative method to solve the linear system of equation. The Gauss-Seidel method is also one method to solve the linear system of equation as Gauss elimination method and Jacobi's method. Okay. So now Gauss-Seidel method says this is a simple modification of Jacobi's method. Yield faster convergence. So here you look what is the difference in technique. Here in this Gauss-Seidel method, very quickly we will get the convergence. So convergence here in Gauss-Seidel method is very faster convergence. So you have to remember among all the available methods, here we will get the faster convergence. Let x11 first, x2 first, up to xn first be the first approximation to the unknown x1, x2, x3 up to xn. Then the second approximations are given by x1 first, and which is equal to, you know, if already we know the linear system of equation, how to write, you know this, we have to write always as a form of a11, we write a11 x1, a11 x1 in this form, plus a12 x2, you know this, we have already discussed in the Gauss elimination method, a12 x2 and so on, okay, and so on up to a1n. We can write here a1n xn, okay. So in this way we can write the linear system of equation. So similarly, you can find out the value in the term of b1, b2, b3. The x11 you will get b1 divided by a11 minus a12 divided by a11 x2 first, and so on up to a1n divided by a11 xn first. Similarly, you will get x22 is equal to b2 by a22 minus a21 by a22, x12 minus a23. Here, you have to learn very quickly, we have changed here the values. This will be clear in the numerical problem, how it look and how you can change the values. So, let's look here. Similarly, you will get x32 and xn2 also in this form. But how it will look in the numerical, that will be more clear to the viewers. Okay, so the entire process, this Gauss-Seidel process, is repeated till the value of x1, x2 up to xn obtained to the accuracy required in the problem. Therefore, we may say that this Gauss-Seidel method uses an important component as soon as available, and so it is called the method of successive displacement, our Gauss-Seidel method. Let us look at an example. Starting with x0, y0, z0, which is 0, 0, 0, solve these linear system of equation. Okay, 54x plus y plus z is equal to 110, 2x plus 15y plus 6z is equal to 72, minus x plus 6y plus 27z is equal to 85. So here you can see this is the, from here you can rewrite the value of x, y and z from these equations. Okay, so and it is also seen the highest coefficient is always here. So this is also, if this is not arranged into the equation, so you note down you have to rearrange the linear system of equation where the coefficient of x here, like in the first problem, this should be with the highest coefficient of x. Okay, here this should be highest coefficient of y, here it should be highest coefficient of z. If it is not arranged, then you can rearrange, but you have to maintain this accuracy. Okay, then only the Gauss-Seidel method may work effectively. Now, for the solution purpose, from the given equations, we may write, as I said here, we may write from here, x is equal to this. You can look here, you can check here. X you can write from here, y you can write from here, and z you can write from here. you will get these equations. X is equal to 110 minus y minus z by 54, y 72 minus 2x minus 6z by 15, and z is 85 plus x minus 6y by 27. Now we may take the initial approximation as x naught, y naught, z naught as 0. So you can put here the zeros, this 0, this 0, so this will get 110 by 54. So this will be your first approximation. First approximation is x1 is equal to 110 by 54. The value will be 2.0370. Now you mind it. This is the technique. This is very important technique adopted by Gauss-Seidel. Y1 is equal to, if you look the previous example, then here you got x1. You immediately you replace here. X will be replaced by x1. Means 72 minus 2x1 minus 6 z0. So here it was x0. X0 ko apne turant replace kar diya x1 se. And then after putting all the values, you will get 4.5284. Now similarly z1, now you have x1 and y1 both, immediately x0 will be replaced by x1, okay, and y0 will be replaced by y1. In this way, you got a new equation, that is 85 plus x1 minus 6 y1 by 27. This is the main technique of Gauss-Seidel method. This is the main technique, okay. So now after putting this value, you will go for further approximation, means second approximation. So x2 is equal to 110 minus, again you look, here it was y0. So y0 now will be replaced by y1. So minus y1 minus z0. Z0 will be replaced by z1 divided by 54. So the value is 1.9122. Similarly y2. Y2 will be replaced 72 minus 2x2, because here immediately the repeating the similar process. Here immediately you can replace x2. Okay. Minus 6z1 by 15. This is equal to 3.6581. Now you got x2 and y2 both. So you can replace here. The x2 from here means x1 will be replaced by x2 and y1 will be replaced by y2. So here in this way, we have 85 plus x2 minus 6 y2 by 27. Here we got 2.4061. Now repeating the process further, you will get x3. X3 will be replaced here. 110 minus this y1 will be replaced by y2 and z1 by z2 by 54. So value is 1.9247. Similarly y3, 72 minus 2x3. Here you got x3, so this x3. 2x3 minus 6z2 by 15. Okay, it's equal to 3.5809. z3 similarly, you got x3 and y3 both here. 35 plus x3 minus 6y3 by 27. The value is 2.4237. Now similarly, the fourth iteration. Fourth approximation, you will get 110 minus, you got y3. So y3 minus z3 by 54. The value is 1.9258. Check it here. This is closer. The values are convergence are now closer. Y4 similarly 72 minus 2x4 minus 6 z3 by 15. 3.57. Okay. Here 3.58. z4 is 85 plus x4 minus 6 y4 by 27. This is 2.4253. This is 2.4237. Similarly, we can go ahead for fifth approximation. And this x5, you will get 110 minus y4 minus z4 by 54. And the value is 1.9259. And y5 is, again, similarly, you get 3.5732. And z5 is 2.4254. In this way, you may report the values. That is, x, the value of x. The value of x is 1.926, the value of y is 3.53, and the value of z is 2.5. Okay, so in this way, you got the values of x, y, and z. Thank you very much. Thank you.